Het jaar 1811 is een van de mijlpalen geweest in de ontwikkeling van de advocatuur in ons land. Met de komst van de Fransen, hun wetten en hun rechtspraak zou er voor advocaten heel veel veranderen. We zijn hier in de Rolzaal, een van de oudste gedeelten van het Binnenhof, dat ten tijde van de Republiek gebruikt werd als zittingszaal van het Hof van Holland en Zeeland. In die tijd gold nog dat advocaten alleen waren gebonden aan de regels die aan hen werden opgelegd door het Hof en de rechtbank.
These rules varied throughout the country, as did the legal system itself during the years of the Dutch Republic. The bar itself imposed no rules. Moreover, it was the local judge who saw to it that lawyers acted in agreement with their professional duties. If need be, those judges would also take disciplinary action. In France, the situation was completely different. Since the Middle Ages, lawyers had found ways to progressively organize themselves. Slowly but surely, they had managed to shake off direct supervision of the so-called parliaments, the royal courts. In Paris, but also in other cities, bar associations had emerged. These bars would govern themselves and decided who was actually admitted to the bar. The bars remained in charge of the legal profession until, in 1789, the French Revolution broke out. The Third Estate organized itself into a National Assembly, which was joined by many lawyers. The National Assembly made a radical change. The old legal system was demolished entirely. Laws were adopted that made it possible for people to either defend themselves or a fellow citizen in court. At the same time, both the title of advocate and the bars were abolished. To the revolutionary regime, these bars were no more than elite organizations, guilds at the service of the ancien regime that had to be destroyed. But this new policy led to chaos and disorder. By this time, almost anybody could perform as a legal counsel. Quality requirements were no longer taken into account. In 1804, those practices were put to an end. A law was adopted that not only reorganized legal education, but also reintroduced the title of advocate. The practical implementation of the order and discipline of the bar would be laid down in an imperial decree. This decree was not issued until 1810, as Napoleon distrusted the independency of the lawyers. So he took great care that the reinstated bars were placed under the supervision of his Attorney General at the Imperial Court. On Friday, the 14th of December 1810, the Imperial Decree was signed by Napoleon at the Tuileries Palace. The reinstatement of the bar associations in France was a fact.
Intussen was ons land gespaard gebleven van de gruwelen van de Franse Revolutie. De Bataafse Republiek had in 1806 plaatsgemaakt voor het Koninkrijk Holland, waar Napoleon zijn broer Lodewijk op de troon had gezet. En de nieuwe koning pakte zijn voornemen om staat en bestuur te centraliseren voortvarend op.
He had ordered a bill on the judiciary and the administration of justice in which the position of the lawyers was laid down. In the new judicial system they would operate as so-called partisans. However, the bill was never adopted. By this time, Napoleon had become fed up with Louis's attitude. He considered his younger brother not to act in the best interest of the empire. In the summer of 1810, the Kingdom of Holland was completely taken over by the French Empire, and in early 1811, French law was implemented. The imperial court took up residence in Noord-Einde Palace, and the legal profession was modeled after France's example. From now on, all lawyers had to be registered and the bar associations and the disciplinary councils were introduced. And so, the modern legal profession in the Netherlands was eventually established. The French domination lasted for more than 3 years. In 1813, Napoleon suffered heavy defeat at Leipzig. The French left the country in a rush and on the 3rd of November the Prince of Orange returned from exile in England. The new monarch, William I, maintained the French rules until Dutch law could be implemented. But Dutch legislation was not yet finished. And by the time the legislative committee was finally ready, around 1830, and preparations were made to implement the laws, the Belgian Revolution broke out. Because of this delay, the Imperial Decree of 1810 continued to be applicable on the Dutch advocates. This was the situation until 1838. At the stroke of midnight from the last day of September to the 1st of October, the French rules were abolished and new Dutch law came into effect. A new regulation was adopted for the order and discipline of advocates. However, that regulation was in many respects similar to the old French rules.
Die Franse regels waren weliswaar na 1838 verdwenen, maar hun organisatievorm voor de advocatuur is gebleven. Het bestuur van de orders wordt al lang niet meer benoemd door de procureur-generaal, maar door de advocaten zelf gekozen. In 1952 kreeg de balie met de advocatenwet een wettelijk verankerde positie en er kwam een landelijke orde van advocaten.
Despite these developments, advocates in the Netherlands are still sworn in at their district courts and are subsequently registered on the roll. They are still part of a local bar by which they are supervised. And they still have to comply with the professional rules monitored by the disciplinary courts. In fact, just as it was implemented 200 years ago, by an imperial decree from France.